Trying to solve one problem of the Rankine cycle, which is very important. Okay, but due to the insufficient time, I could not complete that. So today I shall complete that numerical first, and then we shall move to our next topic, that is the Breton cycle. Okay, and practice as much as problems in your home, okay, as possible, because for me it is not possible to solve many problems because we have limited time available with us. But I can show you one or two problems related to a particular topic, but rest examples or other problems you have to solve by your own. And if you find any difficulty while solving, then you can ping me, I'll help you. But you are the one who has to practice more and more questions, okay? So let's discuss. Okay, so is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So this was the problem we were discussing about in the last class. The question says a steam power plant is operating on the ideal Rankine cycle. Okay, that means what? We have to deal with the ideal Rankine cycle. Steam enters a turbine at 3 megapascal and 350 degrees centigrade, and it is condensed in the condenser at a pressure of 75 kilopascal. Find the cycle efficiency. Okay, so as I was discussing in the last class, you are familiar with the process of the Rankine cycle. Okay, and you must have the ability to draw the TS plot of the Rankine cycle. Otherwise, you cannot proceed in this type of problem. So what is the TS plot? You are very much aware. Okay, let me draw it quickly. So this is the TS plot. This is the vapor dome, okay, which is generally plotted. Okay, now in the last class, I had shown you how to proceed. First of all, for the corresponding boiler pressure, that means at the pressure where the steam is just entering the turbine, at that pressure we will see what is the saturation temperature. Okay, so from the steam table in last class, we have seen that for the 3 megapascal, the saturation temperature was about 230 degrees centigrade. Okay, but here the given temperature is 350 degrees centigrade. From here we can conclude that the condition of the steam is superheated because it is more than the saturated temperature. So our ideal Rankine cycle would be plotted like this. Like this. Okay. So because we have to bring the steam into the superheated region. So this from 1 to 2, suppose if we are talking about, this is the expansion process which is happening in the turbine. 2 to 3. Okay. 2 to 3, it is what? It is the condensation process. Now 3 to 4. This is the heat addition in the, sorry, this is the pump work. 3 to 4 is the pump work. And 4 to 1, it is the heat addition in the boiler. So these are the four processes of the Rankine cycle. And according to that, we have to find the different data from the steam table so that we can find the efficiency. Because in the last class, I have explained you that efficiency in Rankine cycle, it is in terms of enthalpy. Okay, so we must know the enthalpy at different points. Once we calculate the enthalpy at different points, we can easily calculate the efficiency. You can see the formula. This is the formula for the efficiency of a Rankine cycle. Okay, and we are not neglecting the pump work here because it is in our question. It is in the question, it has not been mentioned that we have to neglect the pump work. So that is why we are not neglecting. So if we are not neglecting the pump work, then we can use this formula, that is eta efficiency is H1 minus H2 minus H4 minus H3 by H1 minus H4. So you can understand that at different points we have to find the enthalpy. H is nothing but the enthalpy. Okay, so using these conditions of the steam, that different pressure and temperature, we have to calculate the enthalpy from the steam table. Okay, and if suppose in the question we have given that we have to neglect the pump work, then we can go for this formula. Eta equal to H1 minus H2 by H1 minus H4. So from here you can understand that H3, that is enthalpy at point 3, it is not used. Okay, so when we are about to find the cycle efficiency by neglecting the pump work, then at point 3, if we don't find the enthalpy, then it is okay. We don't need to find that. Okay, but in question it has not been said that, so we will find the enthalpy at each and every point. Okay. So this was our question. Now let's move towards the solution. I have explained you till this diagram. Okay, so let me just quickly remind you. So this process 1, 2, 2, this is the expansion in the turbine. Is it clear? Okay. 2, 2, 3, this is the condensation process that is happening in the condenser. 3 to 4, very small portion, you can say this is the pump work. And 4 to 1, this is what? This is
boiler heat addition.
Boiler heat addition. Okay, so now we have to find the enthalpy at different point. First of all, we will find the enthalpy at point 1. So we know that point 1 is in superheated region. So we will see corresponding to this pressure, that is the 30 bar pressure or 3 megapascal pressure from the steam table. Okay, and temperature is known to us. What is the temperature at point 1? What is the temperature at point 1? You can see 350 degrees centigrade. It is mentioned in the question. Okay. So corresponding to 350 degrees centigrade and this 30 bar pressure or 3 megapascal pressure, using the steam table, we can find the what? Enthalpy. So you can see here. You can see here. H1 is 3117.5 kilojoule per kg from the steam table. I have taken this value. Okay. Now, similarly, entropy at point 1 can also be calculated. Entropy at point 1 will also be calculated using the steam table. Yes or no? Sir, get bumped away. At point 1, steam entropy can also be calculated?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just by using the steam table. So you can see here we have written entropy. Now you might think, why do we need to find entropy? Because in enthalpy, in efficiency term, there is no mentioning of entropy. But you can see the process here. Okay, this expansion is taking place from 1 to 2, and point 2 is in between this F and G point. Okay, F and G point. So we have to find the dryness fraction, okay, to calculate the different values. That is why we are taking the term entropy here. If we do not calculate the dryness fraction, then we cannot proceed. Okay, and in the formula for the entropy or enthalpy or specific volume, there is the term dryness fraction there. Okay, so we are just taking the term entropy because we can find the different values of entropy, okay, and at different point using the steam table, and we can calculate the dryness fraction. That is why we are using the term entropy also. You will see the solution. Once you will see the solution, you can understand the topic. Okay. Now you can see the S1 is 6.747 using the steam table. Okay. For the superheated region at 350 degrees centigrade and 3 megapascal pressure, we can find the entropy as well. Now tell me, what would be the entropy at point 2? If we know the value of entropy at point 1, then can we find the value of entropy at point 2?
Entropy is constant.
Entropy is constant because from 1 to 2, the process is what? It is isentropic process because it is happening in the turbine. Okay. So whatever the entropy is there at point 1, it will remain same at point 2. That is why we have used the term entropy here. Okay. So at point 2, we can calculate the entropy, but we cannot calculate the enthalpy, but we can calculate the entropy. So you can see S2 equal to S1 equal to 6.747 because entropy is remaining constant here. Okay, now according to the formula, if we want to find the value of entropy between the saturated liquid point and saturated vapor point, then we use this formula. S2 equal to SF plus XFG. You are very much aware of this. Okay, SF is what? This is the point F, the entropy at this point. And this can easily be calculated from the steam table because we know the corresponding pressure here. So we will see the corresponding steam table for the pressure, and for the saturated liquid point, that is at point F, we can easily calculate the entropy. Okay. And SFG, that is the difference of entropy between the gaseous phase and the liquid phase. Okay. So it can also be found out from the steam table because SFG is also given in the steam table corresponding to 75 kilopascal pressure. Okay, so you can see SFG is 6.235. This value is also taken from the steam table. So from here you can see that H2 is known to us. You can see H2 is known to us. SF is found out from the steam table. SFG is found out from the steam table. Then can we calculate the value of X here? out of four terms, three are known. Just only unknown is x. So we can calculate the value of x here. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So you can see while when we put the different values here and solve for x, we can find the value of x as 0.87. So we can see that we have found out the dryness fraction. We have found out the dryness fraction at 0.2. That means what? After the expansion is taking place, what is the condition of the steam, or what is the quality of the steam? Okay, so we have calculated this. Now let's proceed further. Okay, this is the value of x. Now we have to find out, first of all, let's see about the pump work. Okay. Pump work. Now, at which process pump work is happening? From 3 to 4. No. And in last class, I had told you this formula. Vf P4 minus P3 equal to H4 minus H3. Vf is what? This is the specific volume, and it remains constant for the water. Okay. Wp equal to H4 minus H3. You can easily see H4 minus H3. Whatever the enthalpy difference at 0.4 and 0.3, it will be the pump work, H4 minus H3. No. So we can write here Wp, which is equal to H4 minus H3, and it would be equal to Vf into P4 minus 3, whatever the specific volume multiplied by the pressure difference. Now Vf is what? The specific volume at point 3 or point F. It can be found out using steam table corresponding to this pressure. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So you can see Vf, we have found out it is 0.001038 meter cube per kg. It is taken from the steam table. So you should not worry about this, how this value came. Now P4 and P3, can you tell me, is P4 and P3 is known to us or not? P4 and P3 is known to us or not? Tell me, P4 and P3 is known to us, whether we know the value of P4 and P3 or not. Please don't remain silent. Just tell me whether we know or not. By seeing this diagram, or by seeing the question, please tell me whether you know the value of P4 and P3 or not. Do you know the value of pressure at 0.4 and 0.3?
Yes, sir.
How?
Sir, because sir, same pressure applying on sir 1 and 4, sir.
Yes, because you know that in TS plot, this line are constant pressure line, this or whatever the line we draw. Okay, these are constant pressure line. So you can see here 0.4 is lying in this curve, and the value of this pressure is given, that is the boiler pressure is given, that is 30 bar. So we know the value of pressure at 0.4. This is the same pressure here. Similarly, pressure at 0.3, this is the same condenser pressure here. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we know the value of P4 and P3 as well. Okay, now see the solution. P4, you can see that is 30 bar, and P3 is 0.75 bar. Now just apply the here Vf into P4 minus P3. Now it is multiplied by 10 to the power 5. Okay, to convert according to the standard unit. Okay, so you can see here 0.001038, that is the value of Vf. P4 is 30. Okay, and P3 is 0.75 equal to H4 minus H3. So from here, you can find the value of H4 minus H3 is 3088.05. Okay, that is joule per kg. And if you want to convert it in kilojoule per kg, then just then you can see, just divide with 1000. So it will be 3.08 kilojoule per kg. Now see the diagram again. Okay, H4 and H3. H4 minus H3 is this one. So we can write H4 equal to H3 plus 3.08 just from this equation. Just from this equation, can we write H4 equal to H3 plus 3.08?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell me, the H3 can be known, can we find out using the steam table or not? At point three, the enthalpy is, can we find the enthalpy at point three using the steam table?
Yes, sir.
How do we find the steam, the enthalpy at point three from the steam table? Because you can see point three is a saturated liquid point. Okay, and corresponding pressure is known to us. So if we will see the steam table for 0.75 bar or 75 kilopascal, okay, and find the value at HF, then it is the enthalpy at 0.3 simply. Okay, so this value is easily find out, easily calculated from the steam table. So you can see here, H4 equal to 3.08 plus H3, and H3 is 385.9 from the steam table. So from here we can see the value of H4 is 388.98 kilojoule per kg. Now let's move. Now we have to find out the turbine work. Turbine work is what? H1 minus H2. Okay. So H1 minus H2, just see here. H1 value is known to us, okay, and H2, we have now just find out the dryness fraction. You can see, where is the dryness fraction gone? This is the dryness fraction we have found out. So using this formula, just replace H2 with H2, because in the previous classes I told you that this formula is same for entropy, enthalpy, specific volume. Just replace S with H or H with V, you can find the values at the between two saturated points. So you replace S with H, then H2 equal to HF plus X HFG. Now X value is known to you, H1 is known to you, HFG is known to you, then you can calculate the H2 as well. Okay, so from here you can find out the value of H2. Now you can see this is 2367.49. I have not solved this, but it is, I have directly written here. Okay, now H1 is already calculated 311.7 from the steam table. So you can see H1 minus H2 is 750.01. Okay, pump work we have just calculated, WP, that is 3.08. You can see H4 minus H3. Okay, heat addition in boiler is what? From which process heat addition is taking place in the boiler? Which points are representing the heat addition in the boiler?
Sir, 4 to 1, sir.
4 to 1. So H1 minus H4 is the heat addition in the boiler?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you can see Q1, that is the heat addition in the boiler, is H1 minus H4. H1 is known to us, H4 is known to us. So if you calculate, you will get 2728.52. Now if you find the efficiency of the cycle, that is WT minus WP by Q1, or simply you can write in terms of enthalpy, that is 750.01 minus 3.08 by 2728.52 into 100%. So we will find the value as 27.37%. So question looks very easy. You can see the question. You may think that it is very easy. And question is easy. I won't say it is difficult, but you should know how to use the steam table. Okay, and your command in this topic will only be achieved if you solve more problems. Just by solving one or two problem, you will not have the command. Okay, once you will solve three or four problems and you will see the steam table by your own and put the data from the there, then only you can solve this type of question in exam. Otherwise, you will make mistake in the exam for sure. Okay, so is this question clear to you, or you have any doubt, you can ask me. See, one thing just I wanted to say you. Okay, this is the typical Rankine cycle plot for the superheated region. Okay, so the thing is that you have to understand that, first of all, you must understand that how to draw the Rankine cycle. Okay, so you can see the only difficulty you will find, that is the how to draw this expansion process from 1 to 2. Okay, and according to the condition of the question, you will have to draw this 1 to 2, because this 1 to 2 process, just let me show you. This 1 to 2 process, this is, suppose this is the process 4 where the heat addition in the boiler starts. Okay, and this process 4, it can end at point at here also, or at here also. Now, the question is that at which point you will show the expansion? The expansion can take place here also, or here also. Now, you have to understand where the expansion is taking place, and you have to understand it through the given condition in the question. Okay, there would be certain condition in the question which is which you have to apply there, and you can find out whether this expansion is taking place in superheated region or in saturated region or in liquid plus vapor phase. Okay, now in our question, what was the condition? You can see the question was saying that steam enters the turbine at 3 megapascal and 350 degrees centigrade. So generally in this type of question, what will you see? You will see the steam table for saturated region corresponding to the pressure. Remember, pressure. Okay, when you will look into the steam table for 3 megapascal, okay, you can calculate the, you can find the value of saturation temperature, because you know this. This is the 3 megapascal line. No, just let me show you. This line is representing 3 megapascal, no, this line. Okay, so this is TS plot. Then tell me one thing, whatever the temperature is here, the same temperature is here or not? Because this is TS plot. So this line represents temperature here. This line also represents temperature here. So the length of this line is same or not?
Same.
That means what? Whatever the temperature is at this point, it is same at this point as well.
Yeah.
But at this point, temperature is quite more. You can see this length of this line is now increased.
Yeah.
Okay. So here, if you look into the steam table, then you can find the saturation temperature. Okay, what is the meaning of saturation temperature? The temperature at this point or this point, because the temperature is same at this point or this point. So in the steam table, the saturation temperature line is given, means that column is given. So corresponding to this pressure, that is in this question, 3 megapascal pressure, okay, you can find the saturation temperature from the steam table. That means what? You can find the value of this temperature. Okay, so if this temperature, okay, if this saturation temperature is more than, sorry, less than the temperature given in the question, then what will happen? In question, we have seen that saturation temperature in the steam table, it was given as around 233 degrees centigrade. okay, in the steam table corresponding to 3 megapascal pressure, the saturation temperature was given as what? Saturation temperature was given as 233 degrees centigrade. But in the question, you can see here, it is clearly mentioned that the steam entering at the turbine at 350 degrees centigrade. So tell me, 350 degrees centigrade is more than 233 or not?
Yes, sir.
So from here, we can understand that what? Our steam is in which zone?
Superheated zone.
Superheated zone, because it is more than the saturated temperature. Okay. So you can see here, we have to expand our line till this point. It is showing that temperature is now more than this saturated pressure, saturated temperature. Okay. So these are the conditions actually which is mentioned in the question, and according to that only you have to expand this line, or you have to show this line. The question is not difficult. Question is easy at all. Once you know the once you are able to plot the diagram, okay, of different processes in TS plot as per Rankine cycle, then using just this formula, okay, you can easily calculate the enthalpy at different points. Okay, some enthalpy could be directly found out from the steam table, and some you have to use the dryness fraction and all. Okay, so just you know this formula, S2 equal to SF plus XFG. Okay, and this is valid for enthalpy as well. You can replace S with H, then you can find the enthalpy at point 2. Okay, at this corresponding, this F and G, between this F and G point. Sorry. Similarly, if you are required to find a specific volume as well, then just replace this S with V. Okay, and using this formula, you can easily calculate the enthalpy at different points. Okay, and once you will able to calculate the enthalpy at different points, you can easily calculate the what? Cycle efficiency. Okay, now tell me, is this question clear to you, or if you have any doubt regarding this question, then you can ask me. Will you be able to solve this question if it is asked in the exam?
Sir.
Everyone? Now it is your duty to practice many few more questions from the topic Rankine cycle. Okay, see from the book one or two questions from the example first. Okay, solve the example first, because in example there is the solution. At any point if you find difficulty, then see the solution, and after the solving example, try one or two questions from the exercise as well. Okay, and if you find any difficulty, then please you can come to me. Okay, I'll try to sort it out. But thing is that you have to practice. Okay, and you must be very fluent in the steam table. Okay, you can easily, you should have the capability that just by seeing the question, you can understand it at which steam table you have to look into. Okay, so you should be very confident about the watching the steam table. Okay, and it is very easy. So till this point, this is the Rankine cycle. Now one important topic that was left, I wanted to show you, that is the Carnot cycle and Rankine cycle. Okay, now you are very much aware about the Carnot cycle as well. Okay, now in exam it is asked several times why we can't use Carnot cycle in a power plant. Actually, Rankine cycle is you can understand that it is simply a modification of the Carnot cycle. Okay, but there are certain limitations of the Carnot cycle. That is why we cannot use it for any practical device. Carnot cycle is ideally best cycle because it has the maximum efficiency, but it is not practically possible. So Carnot cycle is just used to compare any cycle. Okay, so that the value of efficiency is compared with the Carnot efficiency. So if you remember, okay, Carnot cycle, I had taught you. Okay, Carnot cycle consists of two reversible adiabatic process and two reversible isothermal process. Okay, so just see one TS plot, you will able to understand. Okay, this rectangle inside the this plot, okay, this represents what? Carnot cycle. And this represents everything just except this heat addition here. Okay, it represents what? This is the Rankine cycle. Now question comes, why we can't use Carnot cycle in the power plant? Okay, now you can see here, just wait, this 1 to 2 is what? Which process is there, this 1 to 2?
Turbine work, sir.
Turbine work. Okay, now if we go for Rankine cycle, then what is the pump work here? For Rankine cycle, what is the pump work denoting?
3 to 4. 3 to 4, sir. 3 to 4.
3 to 4, which 3 to 4? 4 is 2 points here. 4C and 4R. 3 to which 4?
R, 4, sir.
4R.
4R. 3 to 4R is the pump work. Now, if we go for the Carnot cycle, then what is the pump work here?
Three to four C.
So from here you can understand that the pump work is almost equal to the turbine work. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If we go for the Carnot cycle, then pump work is equal to the turbine work. Because this line represents the turbine work. And this line represents the pump work from the Carnot cycle, from 3 to 4C. So it is same in size or not? Lengthwise.
Yes, sir.
Understood, everyone? Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
You can see this is 1 to 2. This is the length of pump work, sorry, turbine work. And this 3 to 4C, this is the length of pump work. Now, if you are drawing the rectangle, then in rectangle, opposite sides are equal, no? So, this line 1 to 2 or 4C to 3, this is same in length. Okay. So, you can understand that if we use the Carnot cycle, then turbine work is equal to pump work. Okay. So whatever the work is just producing the turbine, the same work we have to put in the pump also. So our cycle efficiency would become what? Zero. Because formula is what? Wt minus Wp, no? By heat addition. So Wt and Wp are equal, then Wt minus Wp would be zero. Understood what I said? So that is why one of the drawback of the Carnot cycle is that we can't use it for the power plant. And another thing is that, see the heat addition in the boiler. Heat addition in the boiler. Now, if we go for the Rankine cycle, then the heat addition in the boiler is starting from the 4R and ending at 1. So from 4R to 1, the temperature is increasing or not? From 4R to 1, temperature is increasing or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because if we see the TS plot, this line represents temperature. So this is the initial temperature and this is the final temperature. So final temperature is more than initial temperature by seeing the length of the line. Okay, but in case of Carnot cycle, the heat addition is from 4C to 1. Can you see? Heat addition is from 4C to 1. So is temperature increasing from 4C to 1?
No, sir, it's constant.
It's constant because the basic of the Carnot cycle says that heat addition takes place in the constant isothermal heat addition takes place in case of Carnot cycle, which is practically impossible. When you are applying heat, in boiler, you are adding heat to the water and its temperature is not increased, it is not possible. When you are heating the water and its temperature is not increasing, is it possible?
No, sir.
No, it is not possible practically. So that is why one of the reason is that Carnot cycle cannot be implemented in practical or in steam power plant. Okay, so these are, you can understand that why we can't go for the Carnot cycle in power plant, thermal power plant. That is why the Carnot cycle was modified and it was known as the Rankine cycle, which is practically possible to implement in a power plant. Okay, and there are other processes as well. You can see if we go for Carnot cycle, then 1-2 expansion is always takes place between this liquid plus vapor zone. Okay, because in Carnot cycle, this line, just wanted to show you, this line is always remain horizontal. We cannot go for superheated region. Okay, so it is not possible to expand the steam in the superheated region for if we go for the Carnot cycle. Okay, otherwise from the here we have to heat so much, so it is not practically possible to go for the Carnot cycle. And in exam it has been asked several times why Carnot cycle is not used in the steam power plant. Then you should write these few points, and there are brief explanation has been mentioned in the book also. You can go for that and just draw on this diagram and write those things which I told. You will get the marks. Okay, now very important one is the Breton cycle. Okay, let's discuss briefly about Breton cycle. We don't have enough time, but let's say whatever the thing it is possible. Breton cycle is what? It is the cycle which is used, okay, in gas power plant. In steam power plant, our working fluid is what? Steam. We expand the steam in the turbine. But in gas power plant, okay, we expand the mixture of gas and fuel in the what? Turbine. Okay, and this Breton cycle is the main cycle, or it is the cycle responsible for working of the aeroplane. Using this phenomena, the Breton cycle, a aeroplane works. And how this works, let me explain it. Okay, so Breton cycle also consists of four processes, and one thing you please try to remember, the Breton cycle is also known as Joule cycle. Sometimes it is given in the question as Joule cycle, so don't get confused about Breton cycle and Joule cycle, both are same. Okay, so you can see there are a few devices which is available or which is used for the Breton cycle. One is the compressor. You can see this is the compressor. Okay, then there is the combustion chamber where the combustion will take place. Then there is a turbine. Okay, now this cycle, this Breton cycle could be closed cycle also and could be open cycle also. Now this is the diagram which has been shown here. It is the open cycle. So what is the processes that happens here? Just let me explain you. Okay, first of all, air from the atmosphere. Okay, atmospheric air is taken to the compressor. You can see this is the compressor. Okay, air is coming from the atmosphere to the compressor. Now compressor, what will do? It will compress the air. So as a result, after, if the compression takes place, then volume increases or decreases?
Sir, decreases, sir.
Decreases. Okay, when compression takes place, volume decreases and temperature
increases, sir.
Increases.
Temperature increases. Okay, and pressure?
Pressure also increases, sir.
Increase, sir.
Pressure increases. Okay, so volume decreases but pressure increases. So from here you can see we have passed the air here. So its volume decreased and pressure increased. Okay, now this compressed air, it is now taken to the combustion chamber. Okay, now from the combustion chamber, fuel will be spread. Okay, now in the case of aeroplane, the jet fuel which is used, okay, it is now spread. Okay, as the fuel and air mixture is now here, so ignition will take place. Okay, the combustion will take place, and the mixture of this as a result, what will happen? The mixture of this air and fuel, it will burn and flue gas will come out. Okay, and that mixture, now it is expanded in the turbine. So what will happen? Turbine will rotate.
Yes, sir.
Okay, turbine will rotate and it will produce some work, that is suppose WT. Okay, and the whatever the exhaust we have now after the expansion, that is now left, that is the exhaust product, it is now further thrown to the atmosphere. So this is called the, this is the working of the Brayton cycle. Now this exhaust, if we reuse it again, if we provide to the compressor, okay, then it is called closed Brayton cycle. And the exhaust, it is not reused, okay, and it is thrown to the atmosphere, then it is the open Brayton cycle. So have you understood the four processes? Okay, now with the turbine, just as in case of any steam power plant, there is a generator also attached. You can see here a generator is attached. Now as the turbine rotates, this generator produces electricity which is further sent for the consumer. Okay, and the turbine and compressor are connected with a shaft. That means what? The compressor, okay, we have to run the compressor. So this compressor takes the power from the turbine. Okay, now if we don't use the generator here, if we don't use the generator here, then this type of arrangement only without the generator, it is used in what? Aircraft. So in aircraft, what happens? The you may have seen that when the in the wings of the aircraft, there is a cylindrical shape, huge fans are there, no? So when this fans rotates, it sucks air from the atmosphere. Okay, and there is a combustion chamber. This there is a compressor available there. Okay, after the air is being compressed, the fuel, that is the jet fuel which is used in the aircraft, it is given in the combustion chamber, and as a result, this turbine, this jet turbine in the aircraft, it rotates, which gives the power to the engine. Understood? So this Brayton cycle is the main cycle which is responsible for the running of an aeroplane also. Okay, and this same cycle is used for the generating of electricity, gas power plant. Now gas power plants are generally used in those places where the shortage of water is there. Okay, in many Gulf countries where the water, where the river is not available and where the water shortage is there, at those places this type of gas turbine is used. Gas turbine power plant is used to generate the electricity, because in a steam power plant you need a lot of water, continuous water supply to convert the electricity, convert the water into steam. But if you are having lack of water, okay, you are not having sufficient amount of water, then you cannot go for the steam power plant. So at those places where the water shortage is there, okay, at those places that gas power plant is generally used. So these are four processes of the Brayton cycle. From A to B, you can see from A to B, reversible adiabatic compression, air is compressed and it, this process takes place, reversible adiabatic, that means what? Isentropic process. So from A to B, the process is isentropic. Now you can see at point B, volume is more. At point A, volume is more. At point B, volume is less. Okay, but at point A, pressure is less, and point B, pressure is more. So before compression, the volume is more, but after compression, volume is less. And before compression, pressure is less, and after compression, pressure is more. Okay, so A to B, reversible adiabatic compression. B to C, constant pressure heat addition. You can see from B to C, at this process, the compressed air is now in the combustion chamber where fuel will burn and heat addition will take place. So you can see from B to C, the pressure is constant. Whatever the pressure is point B, the same pressure is point C. So from B to C, combustion is taking place, the, or you can understand that pressure is constant. B to C, constant pressure heat addition. C to D, reversible adiabatic expansion. Now C to D, this mixture is now expanding in the turbine. So from here, C to D, reversible adiabatic. This expansion is also reversible adiabatic. That is isentropic. Whatever the entropy is point C, it will remain at point, same at point D. Okay. So as an expansion, you can understand that volume is now increased. Initially, the volume is this much at point C, and at point D, volume is now increased. Okay. It is expansion is just opposite of compression. No. In the compression, if the volume decreases, then in expansion, the volume will increase. Okay, so from C to D, volume is increasing. So this is reversible adiabatic expansion. Okay, from D to A, if you go for the closed cycle, then this exhaust will now further use. So from D to A, constant pressure heat rejection will be there. Heat will be rejected from this exhaust gas, okay, at constant pressure. So you have understood the four processes. One is expansion, then heat rejection, then compression, then combustion. But if you want to go serially, so first of all, the initial process is compression, then combustion, or you can say the heat addition, then expansion, then exhaust. So these are the four processes that happens in a Breton cycle. And this is the PV diagram, pressure versus volume diagram for a Breton cycle. Okay. So in next class, we will see TS diagram of this Rankine cycle, this Breton cycle, and we will see the formula for its efficiency, how to find the efficiency of a Breton cycle, and we will solve one or two problem related to this Breton cycle. So before coming to the class, please just go through the Breton cycle first once, then you will have clear idea whenever I will teach you. Did you understand the Breton cycle phenomena, how the work takes place?
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
It is not at all difficult. You can understand. Processes are quite easy. Just you have to remember. Okay. So that's all for today. We shall continue our topic of study in next class. Okay. Now for attendance purpose, switch on your camera.